News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Doug Allen.
Wow, check out the view from our Lancaster Sky Cam tonight. Yeah, that's what you need. Don't go out without your foghorn tonight. One more, Chuck. Go ahead. Go ahead, Chuck. Hit him again. Hit him again, Chuck. I guess Chuck fell asleep. We'll recycle our foghorn and bring it back at a later date. Tonight, it is a muggy one out there. It's kind of sticky. Temperature's 55. It feels the same with a light wind from the east. And the dew point is just about halfway up here as well at about 51 degrees right now, 30.20. Visibilities around the Susquehanna Valley are coming down now. And you can see Lancaster reporting zero visibility at the airport. When I last checked, it was at about a quarter mile. And now down to zero, 11 and 2 miles, 4 mile visibility at Harrisburg and Carlisle, 2.5 in York, and about half a mile in Gettysburg. So it's one of those nights where you're going to have to travel carefully because of the fog. And it's likely that this will hang around through the night and probably into the morning commute. Cloudy skies, areas of fog, 48 to 52. So the temperatures will not drop much more tonight. In the morning, cloudy with fog, 55 to 60. There may be a brief shower, a little period of drizzle as this warm front makes its way through here. The showers would end around lunchtime, mostly cloudy for the afternoon. And the temperature's climbing to 68 degrees or thereabouts, and the winds will likely get quite gusty as we get into the second half of the day tomorrow. We're talking in the order of 20-mile-an-hour sustained winds and higher gusts than that. You can be sure the fog won't hang around then. 53 in E-Town. In the capital, 55. York's at 53. It's 47 in Lancaster, 46 in Lebanon. These numbers are likely not going to budge now. I think we're pretty much at our low temperatures. In fact, they may start to creep up a little bit tonight. 52 would be the low temperature or thereabout. You could see that we're in that neighborhood right now. So here's a satellite and the radar view, and you can see the clouds and the fog starting to form up over the Susquehanna Valley right now. And look at all of this cloud cover yet to come. There are a couple of areas of low pressure trekking up through the Mississippi Valley, across the Plain States, and headed up into the Great Lakes regions. And what they'll do is move a warm front through the area tomorrow morning. This is around 8:30. And with any warm front, there's always that chance of some drizzle or some light showers as it goes on by. Then during the day, we'll get into the southerly flow of air. Most of the shower activity stays off to our west during the day, and hopefully for the trick-or-treaters, too. Can't rule out a little spotty shower activity then, but it'll be windy and mild for trick-or-treat tomorrow evening. Then the heavier showers arrive here tomorrow night. They linger into Friday morning, and then we start to clear it out. This is Friday as we go through the afternoon. There's about 3 o'clock, so as we get into football Friday time, should be drying out then, and sky should be clearing as well. Temperatures holding up. Highs tomorrow should be 68, 69 degrees. It's going to be windy outside, too, so bear that in mind. But basically, more clouds and sunshine in the afternoon, unseasonably mild. Even on Friday, with some morning rain around, it's likely we'll get up to about 70. Once the cold front goes by, the air behind it, not all that chilly at first, 62 on Saturday. Then as we go through the weekend, things do cool down a bit. Mid-50s for highs on Sunday and Monday, back to 60 on Tuesday and Wednesday. And of course, you can see our little backwards clock there. So Saturday night, when you go to bed, you roll it back 1 hour. Or if you're a nighttime partier like Janelle and Ron.
Oh, yeah.
2 hours.